welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Mary. Today's topic, learning to listen to God. For as much as the girdle cleaveth to the loins of a man, so have I cause to cleave unto me the whole house of Israel and the whole house of Judah, saith the Lord, that they might be unto me for a people, and for a name, and for a praise, and for a glory. But they would not hear. Jeremiah 13, verse 11. They say listening is the biggest part of communication. I believe this saying is true. After all, how can we effectively connect with others if we don't comprehend what is being said? How about connecting with the Lord? Think about it. We talk a lot when it comes to our prayer, and we should pray because prayer is very biblical. But what is prayer anyway? Is not prayer communication with the Lord? If this is true, then we should learn how to effectively listen to Him, not just talk. Consider the condition Israel was in Jeremiah's day. As a result of their rebellious disease, God told Jeremiah to get a linen girdle. He was to put the girdle on his loins and not allow it to get wet. He was to go to the river Euphrates and hide it in a hole. After many days, Jeremiah was to go back and retrieve the girdle. When he did, he found it to be marred, blemished. God told Jeremiah this was a symbol of how he was going to mar the pride of Judah and Jerusalem. Why? Very simple. They refused to hear God. What kind of things can we do to be better listeners to the Spirit of God? 1. Realize that God is not hard to listen to. The story is told after Elijah slew the prophets of Baal. He received a threat from Jezebel. Elijah ran for his life, and afterwards, Elijah eventually went into a cave. And while he was there in the cave, he expected God to speak to him in a wind. But God did not speak to him by the wind, nor by the earthquake, or even by fire. The scripture said, God spoke to Elijah by a still, small voice. What was God doing? God was showing Elijah that he's a gentle God, easily approachable. It was in a still, small voice that God gave Elijah clear and specific direction. The voice of God is most often heard in quiet humility. Next, give God complete control of your life. Why don't people listen to each other? They don't want to give up any of their own personal control. We humans can be so insecure and afraid to think that just because we listen to somebody means we have to agree with everything. When it comes to God, then it's a different story because God is always right. Yet at the same time, God is far more flexible and full of variety than most people. People struggle to listen to God because they are afraid He might say something they don't want to hear. Another thing that we can do is practice listening and putting ourselves in a daily position to listen to Him. Some of the greatest prayer warriors are people who take time to listen to God. They realize it's just as vital as talking to Him. God wants to protect us from spiritual deafness. What is spiritual deafness, you might ask? There's a form of deafness known to physicians in which a person affected is able to hear everything except words because of an injury deep in the ear, which is linked to the brain itself. All spoken words are unintelligible. You can give that individual a book and they can read it and understand. But every word addressed to the individual through his ear reaches his consciousness only as a sound, not as a word. I pray today that spiritual deafness would not plague any of God's people in these very troubled times. I pray the Lord teaches all of us how to listen to Him and that we might find fellowship and direction that we desire in our lives. My encouragement, child of God, do not just speak to God, but learn to listen. The thought of the day, communication is a two-way street. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.